We'll now talk about the client-centric growth approach, and I want to talk more about how is it done. We are living in an era of hacks. This has been something that's given an impression to many of us that you just need to do one thing and everything else will become hunky-dory. So I see a lot of B2B organizations improve one area or the other, like for example, marketing or digital sales, and they expect that they will get consistent long-term growth after that. Yes, you will, as I mentioned earlier, you will have a happy quarter, but that's it. So what is missing in this kind of an approach is a consistent and a comprehensive system for growth for B2B organizations. This kind of a system includes both the what's and the how's. That is, what is to be changed and how is it to be changed? It has to include both of this. I'll give you an example. One of my clients in the tech space had a stagnating growth, and they were not able to get enough volumes from their existing clients, and they felt that there is no differentiation with respect to competition, so they were not able to win new orders, and they were certainly constant escalations and stuff like that in the delivery also. So as a result, they had to deploy more resources in the delivery, and that was impacting their profitability. So you see, almost all of the things that we talked about, those challenges were present with them. So they wanted to create a wow experience for their clients and thought that that will turn around everything in due course of time and that their clients will start loving them. And that's when they came to me. But I recommended against doing that. In fact, I discouraged them to do anything fancy. If you are in a similar situation, here's what is to be done. First, I get my clients to move from the tag of a vendor to a preferred vendor. And this is done by consistently delivering the promised value to the clients and by addressing issues relating to the core experience of the clients. Consistency and transparency, I would say, is the key mantra here in this stage. Once we pass this stage, in the next stage, I help them to enhance the performance of their deliverables, especially the ones that matter the most to their clients. And for example, if you were offering a 4-day order delivery, going to a 2 days would be a good example of this. But knowing what really is in the minds of the clients is important. Understanding their priorities is very, very important. Without that, randomly trying to improve on all the deliverables, everything else will only make it more difficult for you, more expensive for you to run the operations. I want to bring in one interesting data. As per Forbes Insight, around 45% or so of B2B executives feel that lack of deep customer insights is actually a barrier for them when it comes to implementing effective client-centric strategies. Which means, ultimately, you can deliver enhanced value to your clients only if you understand in reality what the clients are looking for. So with that, the first and the second phase is over, we move to the third phase. In this phase, I help my clients to move from an orbit of, you know, trying to deliver everything at, you know, the best to client intimacy, the orbit of client intimacy. In this phase, the client starts seeing you as a strategic partner. They start seeing you as an advisor. So at this stage, it's no more about how do you win orders. It's no more about, you know, trying to get that extra revenue from the client and stuff like that. The client wants to collaborate with you and you only. And from your angle, it's about how can you better help them succeed in their business. So this stage is not simple. It requires very deep understanding about the client, establishing several internal practices and processes, and investing a lot of time, effort, etc. in building that relationship with the client and their entire organization, not just with few people. That's the kind of work that I'm talking about. And it's the kind of relationship that exists, for example, between IBM and Intel. Their strategic collaboration started, I think, in early 1980s, where IBM was developing PCs and they wanted to engage Intel. That collaboration continues even till date. And that was a turning point for both Intel and IBM's success. This is the kind of collaboration that is representative of this phase, the phase of client intimacy. Now, if you're interested to know more about this Intel and IBM case study in general, I have a fortnightly publication where this case study and similar such case studies are shared, and you will be able to access them. So I'm providing the link below from which you can kind of subscribe to that. So coming back, net-net, the result of all this that I talked about, the three phases that I talked about, is nothing but more business from existing clients and consistent growth, and that too with less stress and struggle. And as byproduct of that is your brand image in the market will improve. You will start acquiring clients with less effort very easily, so your sales win rates will be higher too. And the overall process of how you do this, right? That's also not something that's going to be very complicated. The steps which are needed to be performed, the areas where you need to strengthen yourself, they are simple and straightforward. You have to implement what I call as the client-centric business growth strategy that I've been talking about earlier. We will progress stage by stage by delivering superior value to our clients, purely by understanding our clients, by understanding their business priorities, the nuances in their business, and most importantly, not just understand, but constantly realign ourselves to help them succeed. So I should say, you succeed when your clients succeed, period. By the way, if you are interested to learn more about this client-centric growth approach, you can refer to my book, The Client-Centric Protagonist. In this book, I've extensively covered this three-stage process with many more examples, and you will also find actionable insights from the book. We will talk more about this when we are going to meet in person, but at this point of time, I'll move to the next stage and go a little deeper into this approach of client-centric strategy. How do we do it? That's what I'm going to talk about next.